Before we build an extension, we should ask ourselves one question. Do we have specific business needs that require us to deviate from the standard? To answer this question, the best place to start is SAP Signavio, as it provides a comprehensive overview of our business processes. For our demo, I'm going to use the new benchmark analytics dashboard, part of SAP Signavio Process Transformation Manager. It allows me to compare our process performance against our industry peers. I can easily see that the lead to cash process is not performing as well as it could. To find out more, I'll click the initiatives tab and go to the one related to lead to cash. Here, the issues collected by our process analyst are grouped in so-called insights. Let's open the first one related to sales orders. It shows that 12% need additional manual effort. And as we look closer, we see that the delivery block is not removed automatically after a customer pays an overdue bill. Now, a delivery block can be set for multiple reasons, depending on customer-specific configuration. We only want to remove it automatically if payment has been received. This means we have an automation opportunity. The second one is related to billing. Through process mining, analysts have identified that many high-value bills will be invoiced following the regular billing cycle. If the company were to send out these bills immediately, it could increase liquidity. This means we need to adapt the standard billing process. So to answer our initial question, we do have specific business requirements that deviate from the standard. And that's exactly why we need to build custom extensions. The good news is that we can do this in a cloud-ready and upgrade-stable way by using SAP Build and ABAP Cloud. Let's get started. First, I want to automate the removal of the delivery block check after an overdue bill has been paid. By using the new Build extension wizard, I can start the extension project directly from SAP S/4HANA Cloud. I'm going to create a custom process, and then select business event as my trigger. And here I can find the related business event, which is journal entry created. I'm just going to copy paste a description, sorry, a project name and a description. Perfect. And then after a quick review, I can create the extension project. And from this step, I can launch SAP Build Process Automation. If I open the project, as you can see, the trigger that we selected is already added. From here, and thanks to our low-code portfolio, we can continue to extend and build the process easily while keeping the core clean. But for now, let's turn our attention to the second insight, the one related to high-value bills. In this case, we want to modify a highly integrated business process of the SAP S/4HANA Cloud Core. To do so, we'll use ABAP Cloud and build an on-stack extension following our clean core approach. Specifically, we need to create a custom business object that will maintain different billing limit values for different customer groups. These criteria will be used to issue certain bills outside of the standard billing cycle. I've asked my colleague Rachel, an expert ABAP developer, to record a quick snippet of what that would look like. In Eclipse, where she has ABAP development tools installed, she can use Joule's ABAP developer capabilities to create the custom business object. She can simply follow the new GenAI-based wizard and add her prompt in natural language. As a result, she'll get a list of the ABAP repository objects that will be used for the transactional application. And after a quick publish and preview, thanks to the power of Joule, we have a fully functional SAP Fury application that will help us address our second insight. And she also provided a screenshot of what it would look like after adding some data. Here we can see the customer groups and the related amounts. These are just two examples of how we are simplifying building extensions for SAP S/4HANA Cloud. First, by starting your extension projects directly from your business context with the new Build Extension Wizard. And second, by leveraging Joule to generate ABAP Cloud business objects and accelerate custom development. Now, let's imagine that we finished and deployed our extensions. How would this impact our IT landscape? Are these changes even visible? To answer these questions, we'll turn to SAP LeanIX. With the new SAP Landscape Discovery feature, we can see all our SAP Cloud and on-prem systems. And later this year, we'll also be able to see extensions built on SAP BTP, like the new process automation that we discussed earlier. And it will also be possible to link these extensions to fact sheets and catalogs. But that's not all. With our AI Copilot Joule, we'll also be able to find reports, fact sheets, and more with just a few clicks. So for example, I am going to ask Jewel politely to find the reports that show which applications support our key capabilities and also indicate how they are built. And here we go. As we can see, Jewel not only finds the report, but also provides the link to open it directly. And we see it here with the extension that we also linked. So I realize that I shared a lot of information in just about 5 minutes, and you can certainly visit our demo booths on the show floor to dive deeper into all of these innovations. But before I go, let me try to summarize the most important takeaways. You can easily find improvement opportunities, realize the needed changes while keeping your core clean, and have an up-to-date view of your IT landscape thanks to the combined power of SAP Signavio, SAP LeanIX, and SAP BTP.